The next step of the exercise is to make the events page. Since we already have the home page, we'll go back to it and convert the header into a master so that we can reuse it on the other pages of our prototype. And then I'm starting to build the content of the page. When there's a form field in the page I want to prototype, I actually use Axure widgets that are form fields, in this case the text field, to build my prototype with. It makes the prototype easier to understand if you're using actual form fields rather than, for example, a rectangular square background. And also, it makes making the prototype interactive easier later on. For the same reasons, using the default checkboxes is better than to use stylized images that represent checkboxes. If you see a dialog popping up here, it's because I'm trying to double-click on the text of the checkbox to edit it, and instead I misclick and double-click on the background image, so I'm just closing it because I don't actually want to change the background image. For the actual list of events, I'm just going to design one of the items, and then I'll use a repeater to create the list. It will be a lot faster, and I'm not concerned about putting in the right content immediately. I'm not too concerned about the look and feel either, I just want to make sure that all the elements that I will need are present. Now that I have all the widgets inside my event element, I will select them and use Ctrl X to cut it, and then I'll paste it inside the repeater. So I'll just add a repeater to the page, double click and paste everything using Ctrl V. I'll make sure it's in the top left corner because I don't want to have any edges around the box. I'll count how many items I actually need to display in my list. I'll select the repeater and go to the Properties tab, and at the bottom of the inspector I'll look at the table and add as many lines as I need, knowing that there's already 3 by default, until I reach the number of items I want to have in my list. Then in the Style tab, I want to make sure that I have 2 items on each line. I also want to edit the spacing so that my layout will be similar to what is on the existing site. I need to be inside the page in order to have a decent preview of this and not inside the repeater. And now I'm realizing that something is wrong because even when I set my spacing to 0, there is space in between the columns. Can you guess why? Usually in this case the explanation is very simple, and it's likely that you have some invisible element on the side that's making the area larger, although you can't see anything. And it's fixed. And now I can configure my spacing as I wanted it. I forgot to add the dropdown here, so I'll do it quickly, and I'll just input the first value so that it's working, although you can't select anything inside. Now I'm just going to add the list and grid icon, which is taking a bit of time because the icons in Axure don't always have a intuitive name, let's say, but it's good enough. Just don't waste too much time on looking for the perfect icon when you do this kind of stuff. At this point, I'm just considering using a pulse icon and adding 2 so that it looks like a grid. And there it is. I would have never found it by searching. Just adding two rectangles and writing grid on one and list on the other might have been enough for this prototype. The suggestions block here also exists in other pages, so I'm first checking that it doesn't already exist, and since it doesn't, I'm going to use the repeater technique again to create this list of four items in a row, and then I'll turn it into a master later to be able to reuse it on other pages. I only need one more row in the table to have four items. And now I just have the footer left to do, so I'm going to go back to the home page, turn the footer into a master, and add it to my events page. Cleaning up the prototype a little bit and placing elements in a way that it flows better. Now I can remove the background image, I haven't forgotten anything. Make the page look sketchy. And preview one last time to make sure in the browser that everything looks like I want it to.